dear students, welcome to online maths class. Before going to the session, be ready with notebook, pen, pencil and eraser. Today we are going to see about the new topic, geometry. Students, what you all know about the geometry? Yes, geometry means some drawings, lines, points, etc. So we all know about something about geometry. So I'm going to recall some general information about geometry. First one is a point. A point is an exact position on a plane surface. In this plane surface, if you are putting a dot, is called point. The next one is line. A line is a set of points in a straight path that extends in opposite direction without ending. In a plane surface, if you are drawing a line which extends indefinitely in both directions, how to identify that? Without help of the arrow marks. Both the arrow marks represents, it will extend indefinitely in both directions. This is called line. Move on to the next, line segment. A line segment is a part of a line between two endpoints. We have a line. Line means we have both directions. It extends in both directions. In that particular measured points are called line. So it could not extend indefinitely. It have definite length. The move on to the next is array. Array is also a part of a line. It has one endpoint and extends in one direction without ending. It is, the array is also a part of a line, but it extends only one direction, not in the both direction. It extends in a one direction. Yes, my dears. The next one is types of angles. We have zero angle, acute angle, right angle, obtuse angle and straight angle. What is meant by zero angle? Zero angle means in a protractor, the angle represent on the straight line is called zero angle. Next is acute angle. Acute angle means the angle which is measured below 90 degree. Below 90 degree angles are called from 0 degree to 90 degree are called acute angles. Next is right angle. Right angle means which is equal to 90 degree. Which is equal to 90 degree is called right angle. The next one is obtuse angle. Obtuse means the angle which is measured above 90 degree are called obtuse angle. The last one is straight angle, which is equal to 180 degree. The angle whose measure is equal to 180 degree is called straight angle. Children, now we are moving to the topic, that is complementary and supplementary angle. There is complementary and supplementary angles are called very special pairs of angle. So what is meant by special? Special means something special to be there. So first we'll see what is a complementary and supplementary angle. From that you can understand why they are all special. Yes? Yes. First one is complementary angle. When the sum of the measures of two angles is 90 degree, that pair of angles are called complementary angle. Children, complementary angle means if you are adding any two angles, if you are getting the value as 90 degree, then those angles, that two angles are called complementary angle. So we'll see on the example, will you understand easily. So consider the example, In this first picture, we have two angles, that is 30 degree and 60 degree. If you are adding the two angles, 30 degree and 60 degree, we will get 90 degree. 30 plus 60 is equal to 90 degree. Therefore, 30 and 60 are called complementary angle. The same way, we have the second example. See the picture. We have two angles. What are the two angles? Yes, 70 degree and 20 degree. If you are adding those two angles, we will get 90 degree. Therefore, 70 degree and 20 degree are called complementary angles. My dear, from the above two examples, will you understand what is complementary angle? Now, we are going to see about supplementary angle. The complementary angle means adding 90 degree. The supplementary angle means when the sum of the measures of two angles is 180 degree, the pair of angles are called supplementary angles. So, let's be see on the example, my dears. Yes. The first picture we have, what are the two types of angles? Yes, we have two angles, that is 130 degree and 50 degree. If you are adding those two angles, we will get 180 degree. 130 plus 50, which is equal to 180 degree. Therefore, 130 degree and 50 degree are called supplementary angles. Move on to the second picture. We have two angles. One is 80 degree, other one is 100 degree. If you are adding those two angles, we will get 180 degree. 80 plus 100, which is equal to 180 degree. Therefore, 80 degree and 100 degree are called supplementary angles. So, my dear students, if two angles are given, means we can find they are complementary or supplementary. With the help of adding those two angles, we know that formula also. But if one angle of complementary is given, how to find the other angle? The same way, one measure of supplementary given, how to find the other measure of supplementary angle? That we are going to see now. That we will see with the help of exercise 1.1. Question number 1, the first question is 45 degree. My dears, the question is 45 degree. Now we are going to enter the solution part. Consider this 45 degree as angle 1. Why we are considering the angle 1? Because if you are adding any two angles, we will get 90 degree, means that is complementary. And if you are adding any two angles, we will get 180 degree, means supplementary. The first question is, how to find the other measure of complementary angle? So, we want to find the measure of second angle of complementary angle. So, we are going to find the solution. Sum of the two angles is equal to 90 degree. Angle 1 plus angle 2 is equal to 90 degree. We know angle 1 is 45 degree. And angle 2 we are going to find. So, as such we are writing angle 2. That is equal to 90 degree. If one number we know with plus, and other number we have whole numbers. So, the same formula which is used already. If one plus is there, it's come on to the next side. If left hand side we have a number, we want to find the other angle also. So, that I am taking the angle 1 into the right side. 90 degree minus 45 degree. So, 90 minus 45 is 45. Therefore, angle 2 is 45 degree. We will find the second angle for the complementary angle. If you are adding this 45 and 45, we will get 90 degree. So, 45 degree is the answer for the first sum. The same way, we are going to find the other measure of supplementary angle. In question number 2, first sum 80 degree. My dears, let's see the solution part. Yes. So consider the angle 1 as 80 degree. Why we are considering the angle 1? Because if you are adding any two angles, we will get 180 degree is called supplementary. So we have one angle. So with this angle 1 is equal to 80 degree. So angle 1 plus angle 2 is equal to 180 degree. We know angle 1 as 80. Angle 2 we doesn't know. So we'll write as angle 2, which is equal to 180. If one side is plus, it's come to the other side, you will make it as minus. So 180 minus 80, it is equal to 100 degree. Therefore, the other measure of the supplementary angle is 100 degree. Yes, my dear children, did you all understand what is complementary angle and supplementary angle, and also how to find the second measure of both the angles? Move on to the next part, that is homework. We have the homework in page number 2. Try these. And exercise 1.1, question number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 subdivisions. And question number 2, 2, 3, 4 alone. Okay, today's session is completed. Thank you.